mid of 80s, we had the first results on applications of model checking that were quite encouraging. And also I had established a small team. I had my own team with 10 researchers. And we had very interesting ideas at that time about how to build systems. And of course, at that time, software was not so important. We had people working on software for business, for, yes, business applications, commerce, commercial COBOL. Software, COBOL and things like that. And also in France, you had industry interested in real-time applications. So we had the background that allowed us to understand the importance of these applications. And so we started very much cooperating with some industries, like, okay, these industries, the names disappeared. Okay, it was Telemecanique that became Schneider Electric in Grenoble, and Aerospatial that became Airbus at that time. So these industries were demanding methods for the development of systems that were rigorous and were asking for guarantees. Okay, if you have a software running for on a nuclear plant or an aircraft, they wanted at that time to, the idea was to have fly-by-wire, they wanted guarantees. So they were interested in methods and they thought that our methods could be used. So we've been approached by a company that was producing software at that time, and the name of the company was Verilog, and we created Verimag, which is Verilog plus Imag. Imag was the Institute of Informatics and Applied Mathematics, and this gave Verimag. So this is the way we started Verimag.
Could you please explain the concept of formalization of system design?
Oh, yes. Now we are jumping to something else, okay. But Verimag was about designing systems, in fact. And so design is a universal concept. I mean, you design artifacts in general. Design houses, design bridges, design engines, whatever. So the idea of design is that you start from requirements that reflect your desires, your needs, and then you want to build an artifact. And so this process that leads from requirements to the artifact, this is called design, okay? And engineering is about designing, of course, artifacts. Okay. And design, in fact, involves two steps. One, system design. One step is you start from requirements, you write a software, application software, and then the application software, you run it on a piece of hardware on a platform. So you have these two steps. One is writing the software, and the other is generating from the software the code and all the glue, of course, that will allow the system to interact with the environment. So it's system design is much more complicated than writing, designing software and developing software.
So what does it mean in this situation, correct by construction implementation?
Yes, so these ideas of building systems that are correct by construction, I developed them because I realized sometime in my career, mid-90s, that verification was somehow hopeless. I mean, you cannot develop complex systems based only on verification. Verification does not suffice. And I can explain why later. But so the idea was that you have some recipes about how to build, to make things correct. And the recipes are like theorems that you apply. And I think that the most useful part of computer science is algorithms, protocols, architectures, just recipes about how to do things, okay? And of course, you need some theory about how to combine these results. So this is the idea of correctness by construction. For instance, there are architectures. You know what is a token ring architecture. Token ring architecture is a structure that enforces the way that some components communicate, and this will allow the satisfaction of a property. Each good architecture enforces the satisfaction of a property. So this is the idea of correctness by construction, which I believe is very basic in all engineering, I mean systems engineering discipline.
And somehow this has to certify, to give the user some, you know, trust in the product.
Yes, but this is something, yes, different. So we should use techniques that will provide some evidence, not only to the user, but to the certification authorities, to the institutions that control the quality of the systems we develop, that the system will behave as promised. And this is true of all artifacts we build. If you buy, I don't know, a toaster, this is certified. It is certified that if you use it properly, it will not kill you, okay? For any product you buy, you have certification. So one more reason to have certification for flight controllers, for the critical systems.